Hello, welcome. I would like to ask all of you to please hold your applause until I finish with all of the introductions. My name is Jennifer Moldy. I will be reading the stage directions today.
Audition room, my apartment. This space will eventually serve as the ocean, a ferry boat, and a cathedral. What you're about to see is a mixtape about gender and theater.
A spotlight. Woodsick walks into it. They are ultra femme, a wig probably, a dress that shows off what they have been socialized to think will get them cast as the ingenue. They're wide-eyed because they're not tired of it.
Hi, my name is Katie Woodsick, and I'll be doing a piece from The Children's Hour by Lillian Hellman. I don't love you. We've been very close to each other, of course. I've loved you like a friend, the way thousands of women feel about other women. It's certainly that doesn't mean anything. There's nothing wrong with that. It's perfectly natural that I should be fond of you, that I should... I love you. I love you that way. Maybe the way they said I loved you. Listen to me. I have loved you the way they said. There's always been something wrong. Always, for as long as I can remember. But I never knew it until this happened. You're scared of hearing it. I'm more afraid than you. No, I know you never felt that way about me. But who says I didn't? It's funny. It's all mixed up. There's something in you, and you don't know it, and you don't do anything about it. Suddenly, a child gets bored and lies, and there you are, seeing it for the first time.
The spotlight goes out.
Oh, thank you. When will I hear?
The spotlight is back up.
Hello, I'm Katie Woodsick, and I'll be doing a piece from the time starts now. Okay, great. I don't love you.
The spotlight goes out.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Spotlight up. Maybe a skirt has become pants, or makeup is gone.
Hey, I'm Woodsick. I'll be...
Spotlight out.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
The spotlight comes back up.
I don't get to come out in a casting room. I mean, why should I? If I can't come out there, then there's no reason to tell you more than once. I'm not your daughter. I never was. I'm not going to play a part at my own Thanksgiving, or my own Christmas, or even my own birthday anymore. I'm Woodsick. That's enough.
The spotlight dims. Lights up on a would-be apartment. Would-be because it should be an apartment, but it should also be a casting room. Among the office chairs and a desk for signing in, there is also a mattress, Music Man records, and empty coffee cups. Pages litter the place. Woodsick makes themselves at home. All of the previously worn femme gear is strewn around as well. Maybe they play with it. They eventually leave to get a ghost light and bring it on stage, grabbing a bouquet of roses along the way to play ceremoniously in front of it. Peace. For a moment. Then they remember the audience.
I've always hated the term workaholic, as if it was so bad to bring my work home with me, or if there was something wrong with knowing what I want and doing what I have to in order to get there. And when you love what you do, there's an intimacy with your craft. There's something sacred in the process, and there's something holy about making your bed and your work and being committed to lying in it. There's some days when I choose not to leave the apartment, because if I don't leave the apartment, I won't get misgendered. My roommate isn't going to do it, her dog isn't going to do it, and her boyfriend knows he will get in trouble if he doesn't. But then I remember what brings me home in the first place. It's not always turning a key. Sometimes it's the audition room in itself, a callback without fear, a promise from a director. I have loved theater for over 25 years. Since I saw Music Man and set up chairs in my living room to mimic a train. Home is made up of all the things we love longest, isn't it? And isn't it also the place we hurt the most? The place that scars us as much as it loves us? Theater is an industry that is still very entrenched in the gender binary. There are male and female dressing rooms, character breakdowns that clearly read male and female, and you're told at an early age as an actor what your type is in male and female terms. When I was 31, I was cast in a production of The 39 Steps, where I played over 16 male roles. And though I had played male roles before, it no longer felt like drag to me. Instead, it was an extension of my gender identity. During the production, because of that production, I changed my pronouns from she, her, and hers to they, them, and theirs. I lost friends because of it. I lost work because of it. It is the single hardest and best decision I have ever made. One of the characters I played was Professor Jordan, who is this evil German professor pretending to be an Englishman. Here, I'll do a little bit for you. Mr. Hene, you forced me into a very difficult position. You see, I live here as a respectable citizen. My very best friend is the sheriff of the county. You must realize my whole existence could be jeopardized if I became known that I was not, how shall we say, not what I seem. You see, there's my wife and daughter to think of, but what makes it doubly important that I simply can't let you go on is that I'm just about to convey some very vital information out of the country. So, it seems there is only one option, Mr. Hene. Unless, of course, you decide to join us. You're just the kind of man we need. Sharp, intelligent, cold-blooded, ruthless. And when the war comes, these will be the exact qualities we need. We will give you love, honey. And in return, you will love us, the master race, on our great unstoppable march, commanded eternally by destiny itself. Well, sport, what do you say? Will you join us, honey? Not relevant to current political climates and all. How often do you think about your pronouns? No, seriously. Can we get a little bit more light, please? Thank you. Okay, let's see. How many are we here? Almost. How many of you are men? Oh, raise your hands, please. One. More than 10. I'll just say that. Women? Amazing. Definitely more than 10. How many of you are trans, genderqueer, gender fluid, two-spirit, non-binary, gender non-conforming? Anyone who uses pronouns that aren't she, her, hers, and he, him, his? Oh, fuck yeah! All right, you're the and overtures.
By now, Woodsick is crawling into their bed.
I'm tired of being rejected before being formally rejected. I'm tired of my body speaking before I do. I'm so, so tired.
Blackout. Scene 2. At rise. Darkness. And then?
This is the Theatrical Mustang Podcast. I'm your host, Woodsick. This interview is with Emmett Grosland, trans actor and activist. Emmett is about to fly to Chicago to star in Taylor Mack's Here at Steppenwolf. This past summer, he played Peter Pan with a director who worked with Kathy Rigby.
A light starts to flicker, slowly moving across the stage, tinkling somberly. Get up and follow the light, eventually catching it.